Some people have had issues with this Juice Bike Scrambler, be it the Camped or the Hyper. The battery terminals that come together, they don't exactly fit in all the way, so you're getting a disconnect on bumps sometimes. Today I've got a fix for you that'll take care of all of that. First thing we're gonna do is take the battery off. Whew, that was close. Then we're just gonna take a look at the female terminals in there. They look like they're pushed out all the way, so that's good to go. I don't know if you can get a good look at this or not, but those male ends in there are pushed way back in there, and they're barely making contact with the female ends when the battery's pushed in there. So the next step is to remove this plastic piece up in here and this thing here. Now we're gonna remove this Phillips head right here. This, with a little effort, this will pop off, and we're gonna remove both of these Allen head screws. Making a mental note, the longer one went in the top. Now it's decision time. The safest thing to do would be to disconnect it under the seat at the controller. So I'm gonna show you the safest way. You could try to do it from here, but it would be kind of a pain in the ass. We're gonna actually take this whole thing out and do it on a table or someplace where I know I can do it right. So now I'm gonna need to take the seat off. 10 millimeter to get the seat off, and there's 6 bolts. I took the whole controller out because the tray had some sand in it and I wanted to clean that out. You're gonna wanna find your power wire and clip all the zip ties that are holding it down, and we're gonna remove the whole wire. Working on a night move. Be careful when clipping these zip ties that you don't accidentally clip the wire. That would suck big time. All right, that's all the zip ties. Now we could have this flipped over, but we really don't need to yet. When I reassemble it, I will flip it over to put this piece in. But this rubber thing here should slide right out. I'm gonna have to get a needle nose pliers on there to pull that out. Trying to make some front page driving news. There we go. This is out. Now we can remove the wire. In the summertime. Okay, now we need to take this nut off right here. Don't worry about remembering where these pins line up because you can't mess it up. There's a little key right there, so it's impossible. It only goes in one way. So we're gonna take this off. It's really windy out here today, so it's not the best conditions for filming. Now we're gonna pull this out, not lose the parts. Now this is what we have here. We have no power going to anything, so this is great. We're gonna need to desolder these ends here, but first we'll take that heat shrink off. Okay, so we're just gonna cut this here straight down, lightly, not too hard. That one's gone. Careful you don't cut yourself. That always sucks. Okay. Okay, so just make sure you've got a little water on standby because we wanna cool these off right after we desolder it. Now I'll get the other one. Getting hot. The wire's getting hot. Cool it off quick. I don't know if you can see that from there, but I can already tell you one of them's sticking further out than the other one. This does have a positive and negative on it. All right, here's the trick. We're just gonna take our hot iron. I'm gonna hold it on here and we're gonna just put pressure on it. Keep pressure on it. There we go, keep pressure. Push, push, push. Boom, there we go, cool it off. I'm gonna get some of this excess out of here. So we need to get that wire soldered back in. Okay, now I'm gonna do the same thing, push down on it. Ooh, done, cool it off quick. Okay, so now you can see there's barely any sticking up there. Now we're just gonna have to try and clean up around the edge of it with this razor blade. Get some of that plastic off. There we go. If you're old like me, you might need reading glasses for this. Don't forget your reading glasses. Now the neighbors are jackhammering, so there's gonna be a little background noise. But this is what we want. Remember which one's positive and which one's negative. You don't want to mess up now. Probably won't need much solder, but I need the stuff ready. Be plenty long enough. Hopefully I don't get this wire too hot before it's soldered. To help it out, you want to put a little solder on there. It heats it up way faster. This is the trick. Okay. Now we'll slide it in there. Boom. Cool it off quick. Put that heat shrink in place. Same thing. Put this on first. I don't know how many times I've forgotten to put those on. The trick again. A little more. Gotta be quicker than this. Cool it off. That one took a long time. Cool it. And see what happened to our heat shrink. I'm gonna have to try and cut that shrunken end off. That's done. The prongs are sticking up further. We're ready to reassemble the bike. Now I'm gonna put this back in here. The way it's supposed to go. There we go. Should spin on real nice. If it doesn't, don't force it. You're cross-threading it. Get it good and snug. But don't over tighten it, it's just plastic threads. But you want it snug. Stick this wire in and run it through like that. Bada boom, bada bang. How does it go again? There we go, like that. Remember correctly, the longer one went up top for whatever reason. We're done with that. Now I'm just going to make sure that battery fits in okay. Boom, slides in really nice. I'm just going to take this and I'm going to get it started. I'm not going to worry about sliding it all the way up till the last thing. I just want to use it to help kind of keep these wires, keep the slack off these wires. The angled end goes in first. It's not super easy when you get to the top. Okay, I'm gonna just, that's good enough for now. I'll finish that last. Time to start getting these babies zip tied. I use little zip ties because I like the little ones. With the zip ties, snug them up, but don't crank them down. All right, my outro clip got extremely noisy. I apologize for the wind noise. It's unbelievable. That clip was unusable. I do have a windsock on my Rode mic, but it needs to be tweaked. Apparently it doesn't work good. Wind blows in through the back or something. Anyway, clip the zip tie ends, put the seat on, get everything back the way you had it, and you should never have any problems with your bike shutting off again, at least from there. All right, guys, so that's it. That's how you take care of that problem. I'm gonna do some riding today because once again, it's about mid-60s today and it's really nice. It's windy, but it's nice. I'm back down here by the Ottertail River. There's this little trail that runs alongside the river here. It's really, really nice little ride. It's one of my favorite spots to go. Thanks for watching, guys. Peace. He's bound and down, loaded up and trucking. Are we gonna do what they say can be done? We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm just kind of watching old bandit run.